Strategy and Snark presents Dungeons and Dragons Online. And welcome back. Got a quick one today. We are going to go take a look at the revamped Amber Temple because apparently it got completely overhauled in the time in between when I recorded my video and I was able to post it because of computer issues. So we're going to go redo that one. And rather than re-upload the old video and slice it apart, we're going to keep the old one in there as kind of a historical archive, you know, in case anybody cares about the differences over the years. I was actually thinking about that the other day, that there's quests that get updated and you can't find the old version anymore. So I kind of want to keep that one. But still going to go look at the modern version. Also, a couple of commenters have pointed out something that I did not know, or at least I never paid attention to, okay? As you're running, we're right here in the beginning of Barovia, right? You do the very first quest, you walk out that door, you come here, talk to him, he gives you your level 29 weapon that I was very excited to get. We grabbed it, we kept running. Apparently, if you talk to him again, he just gives you a sentient jewel for it. I've just never talked to him a second time. What does this character even have? This character has the Resolute. So we're going to grab Inquisitive just to have a... I mean, I don't need it. I'm just taking it. Yeah. Did not know that was there. But now you know that that's there. You know, and again, thanks to the commentators. Or comment... I guess commentator would be like a sport. I guess I'm the commentator. You'd be the commenters. Anyway, thank you. That is one of the best things about YouTube is that, you know, I don't have to know everything. Somebody else can walk and be like, hey, did you know this? It's like, no, but now everyone else is going to, too. All right, I need to pop over into the other spot so we can get to Amber Temple. Apparently they also reordered these so that they're in the order that you actually do the quests now, which is helpful because they never... I think I commented on this in our level 10 video, but they don't tell you what the places are called. So Argon's Vault or whatever, the first quest... He doesn't say go to Argon's Vault. He says go to the Temple of the Silver Dragon or whatever it's called. Right? He doesn't actually call it Argon's Vault. So you're guessing and checking which one it is. And now it's intuitive. It's the order that they're in. Alright. I don't think we need any of our hirelings. This character should be plenty strong for this. So. This is going to be the fast version. The not smelling the roses as we go version, like we've been doing on all the other epic and legendary versions of quests. So, the streamlined route. We talk to him. Also, talk to her. So, you used to have to either find her library, huh? So you had to find her. She was always in, like, the same spot, but you had to find her. Now they're just both right here. Both right here. Done. Grab our first password, like always. Now, this is where things get different. Not different to heroic, but different because of the revamp. Instead of having the three passwords we need be randomly spread out here, they are in three specific places, but also in the same random places they were before. So all of the places I could have found it before, those still count. But now there's also a guaranteed place. And assuming I've been reading the map on the wiki correctly, the first one is just right underneath where we start. Hey now. I may not play my character that often anymore, but I'm pretty sure It's rude to shoot a guy in the back. So if I read it right, first thing you do, you drop straight down, run in here, kill Golem, and boom, password number two. Now we're going to go, strangely enough, straight. Our next password, again, assuming I'm reading this right, is actually up there. So we're going to go straight into that statue, which involves climbing the ladder here. And here. And now. Normally this would be, previously, this would be optional to jump through this thing here and then fight this guy. But they've given him purpose. You can, now this is the guaranteed password number, this is password three, the freebie you get at the start, go straight underneath the starting point, straight across, bam, new password. I believe, I don't really know what to do with the levers. The wiki says orange lever turns on all of the teleporters. Three more of these turn off the traps from the tower. I've never bothered with it. We don't need to now. Where we're going to go now... Now, there's a couple ways you can go. So, our goal is to get to the Lich. If you've played the quest before, if you watched the other video, we're going to the Lich. He is the source of the next password. He was always a source. Now he is, again, the guaranteed source. So, ways you can get there. If you're a monk like me, or anybody else with the jump ability, I believe we can just go straight over here. This floor cracks and falls away. So if you can jump, I believe that this is the library right over here. Once we get past the... There's like an invisible lizard frog guy here, right? Hello, frog? Nobody? Alright, nobody home. And we should be in the library. Ta-da! Okay. Reloaded the quest up. So if you can't make that jump, you've got two other options. Option one, can you detect secret doors? Well, can you detect epic level secret doors? As I have complained about multiple times, true seeing is not by itself good enough. But if you can see this door right here, it basically takes you to the end of the quest. But I can't. Actually, if you can't see secret doors at all, and you don't have a restoration scroll like this one, you have to go scrounge through the dungeon looking for the randomly placed Maverus scroll. Now I'm gonna summon Froggo here just to show that this can get to the end of the quest. Froggo is a expensive hireling. You have to spend a lot of real money to get it. But he basically is my search monkey for when I'm playing by myself. But for the purposes of showing this to you, I'm gonna use Froggo. Look. We're here. Look, that's the door we need. Click. Skip the cutscene. This is the sarcophagus of Zulu that Casimir was searching for. You go straight to the end fight. Boom. Talk to Casimir. Boom. Quest done. Under 5 minutes. Okay, done. There's our holy symbol. We don't even have to pick it up. Grab our loot. That's it. That's the whole quest. If you can see secret doors. We never even got the last password. So, because some of these are... this is definitely some changes from the revamp. One, you don't have to find the holy symbol anymore. He just gives it to you, okay? You can completely ignore getting it. You still have to talk to Madame Eva at the beginning of the quest, I'm pretty sure. You just have to talk to her. She'll tell you where the symbol is, but if you don't bother to go get it, because it's just bonus XP, if you don't go get it, he'll bring it to you. Now, let's go this way. We got the library card. So, it was in the library. I could have walked over here and got it. Oh, I can't even go out this way because we don't have the password yet. Okay. Just for the sake of making sure. Because the wiki said something that did not end up being true. So, we were just right up there, right? Boing, jump, and you go that way. So this is if you fall down. You fall down. If you can't make that jump or you fall down the crumbly bridge, we're going to go this way. Pop open a door. Hang a right. There's going to be a flame skull and a angry shadow guy in here. Kick open another door. There's going to be two teleporters. You don't want the far one. You want the one to the left. Boom. We are now on the other side of the door. The crumbly walkway is that way. And this way leads us to the absent-minded lich. This, right here, is the guaranteed password number 4, which you don't actually need to complete the quest. The question is, how do you restore him? So, if you do not have a rogue or somebody who can see epic level secret doors, if you can cast restoration on him, that works. Let's demonstrate. I'm going to raise my skill level here a little bit. Fail. I failed on a 7. I failed on a 12. I don't have great UMD. There we go. He's happy now. Trying to find the library right through there. Password is Maverus. There we go. Click. And that'll take you to the end of the quest. That same room with Casimir, and you go and you fight the 4 guys. Done. You don't need that. He just tells you. If you can't, you have to go through this. Click, 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 click. Okay? The wiki says this is a freebie. It's not. I can sit here and I can search forever and I'll never find the secret door. Because the other way to get... the way you actually drop that force field is you kill him. And you can't kill him without killing his phylactery in the hidden room. I can spot it, but I can't find it. Ever. If you're in here on epic or legendary normal, then this is detectable by true seeing. I'm just somewhere in here, I'm sure I have a true seeing item. It's either true seeing or it's actually free. I'm sure I'm a monk. It might just be automatic from being a monk. Whatever, doesn't matter. Point is, normal mode, you can use true seeing or something, or search, or maybe it's even just really free. On hard or elite, it's not free. So both of the paths require you, or both of the guaranteed paths are going to require search. If you can't search, you have to go find the randomly placed one. And again, I could use Froggo. Boom. Now I can go through there and I could fight the Lich if I wanted to, and it would drop the bubble. I just wanted to make that clear, because the wiki said, at least at this point in time, the wiki said that this was low enough that it was free. Like the fireplace in Invitation to Dinner is actually like a DC of like 5 or something, so low that any character can hit the button and find it. Especially after they're told it's there. But not here. So if you're going to speedrun this quest, make sure you have search, or that somebody can search, or that you have Froggo, or you go by the... There is a rogue hireling you can get at these levels. You can just buy the silver rogue hireling for a measly amount of platinum and he'll find the door for you, right? But if you can do it, don't go this way. Go through the treasury. Finish the quest under 5 minutes. Be done with it. But this is the direction you go if you can't. If you cannot find the door, go out there, go see the heroic version where we explore the whole temple. And those out in one of those rooms, you'll find the other randomly placed Maverus scroll. And then you come up here the same way I showed you, and you go this way, you finish the quest. Whew. There's been a lot of... I did this quest maybe 6 times at this point. Just getting all of the differences down. I am out. We already have... we've already got quite a few other videos in the can. It's just a matter of getting them all out now. So I'm gonna go record that level 10 full tour version. And see you back on the regular video soon. Y'all take care.